Right, good day sa ating lahat. So in this video, I'll be teaching you how you're going to access the learner's account and how you're going to log in your school account of your Office 365. So I'll be demonstrating here the process of how you're going to log in. And since you receive an email, the school account, email, login details or login credentials of your school, so you'll be able to log in that one, and we will go through the process and how you're going to access that account. First is how you're going to activate it and verify your account using the verification method. Now there are three verification methods in Microsoft Office 365 before looking into the dashboard of your Office 365. And after that, we are going to navigate to your Outlook, wherein doon naka-email yung password and also the shared spreadsheet of your learners, wherein nandun yung lahat ng learners account na nakalagay, and you'll be able to download it and copy paste it to the template discussed by Sir Christian Katahan, which was aired during the regional orientation of Microsoft Office 365 for students. So alright, so let us now move on to the demonstration. Right. So first is you have to open your browser and just visit office.com. Right. So I have here. I'm going to sign in with different with another account. Okay. So I'll be using the account of Alegria ES. No? So whoever the ICT coordinator of Alegria ES, so we are going to use your account. But then before I'm going to, you will receive, you will receive the password, the and also the account earlier later on. So after this, just visit your inbox in your debit email. No? So that you can get the login details of your school account. So this time I'm going to use Alegria ES. So for the Microsoft Office 365 account, you have here, right? So the format is, first is your school ID followed by fdp.gov.ph. Don't forget, that is Microsoft Office 365 account. And after that, all you have to do is to click next, and in your email, you found there two password, the new password and the original password. So either you can use either of these two password, depende kung anong password ang mag-work. Okay, so since for this demonstration I'll be using Alegria ES, so I'll be, okay, so let us try the another one, the new password, since makareceive kayo ng new and original password. So alright, okay, so after that you need to update your password. So since that is your first time to log in your account, so all you have to do is update your password. Now here, paste the new password you received in your email. Okay, the new password, paste that here, and you're now going to create your own password. Okay, please be reminded that the new password should be unique, and dapat mayroon pong special characters, numbers, and alphanumeric po siya, so mayroong small and capital letter. So for the Alegria ES, this is only a demonstration, but after this we'll give you another set of password. I will reset your password, wherein you can use that password to go through the process. So I'll be using this password. Okay. Right. Okay. Right. So I am now done, creating the password and sign in. Okay, I'll be clicking no thanks. Okay, so more information, just click next. Alright. So just wait for the, ayan. Okay, just wait for the browser to load, then you'll be prompted with this. Don't lose access to your account. So all you have to do is to set up your phone, email, and also the questions. So for this time, now since I am not the IEC coordinator of the Alegria ES, so, but I'll be putting here security questions, right? So security questions lang muna. So I'll be selecting two. Ayan, the first city, I'll be putting here Alegria. Okay. This is an example. Okay, you can select any of the questions here. Just in case na makalimutan nyo yung password. So, since we're pointed, so, okay, you can go back to these questions. Since this is a video, you can go back for the Alegria ES. You can go back to this video whenever you forget your password. So, father, so I'll be using the name at first school attended. So bawal po siya na magkapareho, no? Yung answer niyo, no, for these three questions. So we will try this one. Okay, let us now try to save this. Okay? But for all of you, no, who will activate your account, your school account, much better that you're going to put your cellphone number, but once you're going to transfer to other school, please, no, don't forget to edit that this school account, because hindi nyo to madala when you're going to transfer. So all you have to do is to edit and add another number for the new IC coordinator of that school, right? Save the answers and finish. Let us now click finish. Right, so you have here, okay, just click yes and wait for the browser to load. Then there you go. This is your dashboard, no, for your Office 365. That is a school account. So you can install Office. You can install Office 365 now using the school account, right? And okay. So ayan. Now this is your dashboard. So since we are going to find the learner's account, no, in your Office 365 dashboard. Okay? So since ito yung dashboard natin, and I think, no, all of you have the idea on the or the interface, no, you have the idea of this interface now. So let us now move to Outlook. Okay? So lahat po ng accounts or mga learners list na nasend po na with the Microsoft Office 365, naka-email po siya sa Outlook ng school account. Okay? So, all we have to do is click account, Outlook, no? Click Outlook and try, you just wait, no, for the browser to load, and then there you go. The first inbox here, that is important inbox, the learner's account. Okay? See? You have here learner's account. Just click on this and there you go. This is an email containing, okay, the policy you have here. You can click the policy. You can instruction po. Mayroon po siyang instruction file. Kung mahirapan kayo, you have here. Just go through with this one. And mayroon po siyang nakalagay dyan, no? The email says that the Department of Education continues with the aim of improving governance by providing tools that promote a culture of collaboration and communication and improve performance of tasks. Okay. With these guidelines on the use of the administration of Microsoft 365 for education is hereby disseminated. So you can review the policy. So by next time, now we are going to review this policy. But for the sake of this video, since we are going to download the learner's account, no, the list of learner's account. Okay. So all learners in your school based on the LIS as of December 2020 and LASF as of 2020 have been issued Microsoft 365 for education accounts. So their accounts, credentials, username, and password can be accessed through this link. So all you have to do is to click this link here. But before that, Let us now continue, go through all of this email. So, ayan, now please ensure that this data be kept confidential and shared only with the concerned account owners, their parents, or their section advisors. So, be advised that the students must be activated their Microsoft 365 Education accounts and set up self-service password reset. Okay? So, yung ginawa natin kanina, that is a self-service password reset, yung naglagay tayo ng security questions. And also, yung, I think, tatlo yun siya, di ba? Email, you have the email, and also the cellphone number. Mayroon instruction dito, so you can click that, can browse that instruction. So, resetting of learner's account can be accessed through the admin portal, admin Microsoft of your division. So, ako lang po yung pwede makapag-access or makapag-reset ng account ni student. Okay? So, mayroon pong nakalagay dito, okay? So, to access learner's credentials, use, okay, ito yung gagamitin po natin, okay? Doon sa admin. Okay? Alright. And, yun po. You can use this learner's credential, no? Ito na yun. Ito yung pinasukan natin. Ito yung email. Ito na yung email na to. Dito natin ma-access yung credentials ng learner. But if you're going to access the admin portal, use, okay, admin portal, we're going to use this. So, ang kaibahan po niya is mayroon po siyang R9. After the at symbol, you have the r9.dep.gov.ph. Here, you can reset, no, the learner's account, no. Kayo din mismo, IC coordinator, you can reset the account of your learner. And same as with my capacity also, that I can reset the ICT coordinator's account. Itong account na to, ako lang yung makapag-reset nito. Okay? That is a school account. Okay? So, yan po. Abiding, no, the Data Privacy Act, do not share the username and password with anyone. Okay? So, let us try to open the learner's credential. Okay? Right? Click natin yung learner's credential and let us wait. So, mayroon pong nakalagay dito. Okay? April 23. Okay? Mayroon rin na-create yung October. So, all we have to do, let us try to open this October, as of October 2020. Yan. So, ito yung learner's account. Okay? Ayan. Ito yung learner's account na na-create from central office with your school. Okay? Now, all you have to do is to copy-paste this account based dun sa template na diniscuss ni Sir Christian. Sir Christian, no? Yung template na yon. Right? Now, ito lang siya. And dagdagan lang natin yung based na sa template, ano yung idadagdag natin, yung team code and the rest of the data or columns na pwede natin idagdag. Right? So, ito yung learner's account and mayroon pa pong isa, ito, as of April 23. So, mayroong na-add po, okay, mayroong na-add na mga learner's account. So, ito yung updated na learner's account from central office. Right? So, all you have to do is to download this account or download this spreadsheet, save as download or download a copy, and there you go, you have the Excel file downloaded to your computer and ready na po siya para doon sa template for the automation of the Microsoft accounts of our students, automation, right? So I think, no, that's all, no, for this video. I hope this video helps you on the distribution or the deployment of your students Microsoft Office 365 account. And if you have some questions, now you can contact your district IC coordinators, and district IC coordinators will contact the division IT ICT section, no, for some queries. And from time to time, the ICT section will always be there, no, to help on different difficulties you encounter during the activation process of this account. So I hope this video helps you, and that's all. Thank you.